Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance Series. Happy Saturday, everybody out there in the mosh pit. I hope you've had a great start to your weekend here. We're still waiting for the next video to cross 5,000 likes. Again, we have some videos that are teetering on the brink of 5,000. A lot of them are the upper 3,000s, lower 4,000s. So if you want to go and support the channel, definitely go check those videos out. Or if you don't want to watch the videos, but you still want to help and support the channel, all you got to do is click the like button, leave a comment. That is the best thing that you can do, and I really do appreciate it. Get your meme of the day, artwork of the day, fantastic artwork of the day, submitted here by, I'm going to say, Phalaris. Hopefully I said that right. Title of thread was, thank you, Sinvicta. I'm fairly new to your content. I thought it would be nice to give you something back. Hope you like it. You helped me greatly to relax with your soothing voice. I really had a bad back in the last 2 weeks. And the only thing that kept me sane was your content. XOXO for real from Germany. Thank you very much, Phalaris. Amazing, amazing ink marker drawing here. I could not have done any better myself in a million years. It looks, I love the shading on that. Again, one of those pictures that you definitely want to go see the full resolution over on the Sinvicta subreddit. Let's hop on in here. Hopefully we have a little bit better of a banger run today than yesterday. Yesterday when we needed some damage really badly. So today's going to be Victor 7, Sierra Kilo, Echo 6, November 0. So we got the Crooked Penny here. And yeah, we definitely needed some damage of any kind yesterday. I mean, even with Tech X, like, we still really did not ball out to the very, very end, thanks largely in part to Eyeable Isle, which, of course, helped out a great deal. That was helped out a great deal, I should say, because of Tech X. Oh, man, I'm tempted. I'm tempted to roll it, but I'm not going to. Oh, didn't mean to do that. I thought that was going to be a regular bomb. So, we have the Crooked Penny, which will sometimes pay out with a doubled everything on the ground payout. So, essentially, like, if you had, like, double item pedestal, not on the ground, sorry, it's everything in the room. So, it's not only stuff on the ground, but also item pedestals, double deals, et cetera, et cetera. And when it works out great. You can use it for the shop, obviously, if you want to steal stuff from the shop, kind of, in a way. But it also has a good chance and a more likely chance to destroy everything in the room and basically give you one penny. And that's a whole lot of fun when that happens. Again, utilizing here, we do have a decent amount of tears rate right now. However, I will say that our damage was not great until we got Synth Oil, of course. 5.58 ain't too shabby. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk in, I'm going to grab these soul hearts and then walk out. But first, I definitely want to go over here and see what else lays upon the horizon. I don't know where I was going with that. I was trying to think of a way to tie it into the Cult of the Lamb, but like I just couldn't. And then it was like Lamb, L-A, Lays, and it just didn't work out. We have a bomb here, and we could go fishing for the secret room, which I think is there, but it's only one bomb, and I don't really want to risk it. In fact, I'm more apt to use a bomb here to see if we can get extra soul hearts. We did not. Yeah, so not a bad start here. We start off with very good amount of HP, good amount of DPS, and, you know, a serviceable space for our item. If it pays out, then great, but if not, then we're just going to be, like, super sad, and everyone will laugh, and it'll just be another day in Isaac, baby. Curse of the Maze. Curse of the Maze is going to shuffle the rooms around periodically when we're going through them. It also will make the layout of the stage pretty much change randomly, but the tiles of the room have to match. So, like, you can't get shuffled and have, like, a big room, like an XL room get shuffled into a little room and then little room shuffled into the big room. Like, it has to be one-to-one in terms of room size. The reason why we're doing this right now is because we're looking for the petrified poop, and also because it would be nice if we could get a little bit of extra money so we could potentially avoid having to, like, destroy everything in the shop that we want, a la the Crooked Penny. We only got one Yabe as well, so key is going to be very important until we can find another one. So now the big question is, do we use the Crooked Penny on a devil deal? And the answer is most likely hell no. The only time that I would ever really even consider it would be if Crooked Penny was actually doing, like, well, and also, like, if we just didn't need the double deal and we had nothing really to lose. Oxyshock is going to be a very good starting item here, as that is going to do an AoE aura, which will afflict everything in the room. You're not going to hit the barrel, are you, Fly? Because I don't remember if you do or not. I don't think you do. Okay. So Toxic Shock, essentially what it does is it will deal AoE damage based on our base damage. Do this. There we go. And it's very good for early on if we need to clear, like, a bunch of rooms and, like, you know, we're going up against a bunch of annoying enemies and stuff. Hey, look at that. That's a big-time play right there. Big time play. We even get a soul heart from the Justice card. That is just amazing. Gilded Key, meh. Doorstop. I mean, we could take the doorstop. Honestly, like, that was such a great payout that I'm just gonna roll with it, man. That was one heck of a payout. This is what I'm talking about with the Crooked Penny. If you get lucky, obviously it's 100% luck based. If you can get lucky, oh man, can you get lucky? Oh, baby. Oh, yeah. Golden cricket leg. Absolutely. We also get a free compass here at the cost of absolutely nothing, hence the term free. We get a soul heart. Probably should have looked what this was, so maybe we could have bought another one. Sun card. Yeah. I'll buy this. And, yeah. We're sticking with the Crooked Penny. You've earned our respect for this run, and I am down for it. So if you just get on a couple of chain payouts with Crooked Penny, you are just laughing and you're having a great time. I think we just got shuffled into the boss room. Yeah, we got shuffled two rooms. That's pretty insane. So Golden Cricket Leg is going to spawn just a ton of Locusts for us, which is just amazing. Get ourselves a movement speed, which is one of the stats that we were kind of lagging behind a little bit. And we get Eye of Belial, which is just a fantastic item. Love it. We could go looking for the Super Seeker Room, which is right here. You just saw Toxic Shock yeet everything out of this room. Well, I mean. Yeah.
Nice sun card, loser!
Well, there's our petrified poop, but we've got the golden cricket leg. That's a little bit better. Just slightly better. Curse of Loss, we can't use the sun card. I mean, we could, but it's a reason to. Obviously, the pass-through damage that we have with Eye Belial is going to be absolutely massive for us here. And that's exactly what we needed. We needed some kind of impact item that's going to make a huge difference early on here. And this combined with Toxic Shock is going to allow us to cut down weaker enemies, the more annoying enemies. We just have to be careful of the death rattles, obviously, as we've already got hit by one. Maybe. Dime. I could have tried to double that dime, but I'd rather have a guaranteed premium item. Look at that. Oh, man. Golden Cricket's leg is just doing it for me. That's not doing it for me, though. And that's exactly what I was talking about in that previous room when I was talking about death rattles. You have to be careful. This would be one hell of a payout if we can get it. I'm going to err on the side of caution here. I really want to get the soul heart, but I also really, really wanted to get Dreamcatcher so we can get those half soul hearts every time we go to a new floor. And also, of course, we get to see what item we're getting. So we need one more penny, and then again, it's a little bit of a risk if I want to roll the Crooked Penny in the shop. I mean, it is kind of worth the risk if we do roll it. Because, I mean, the payout is huge. We get two soul hearts for the price of none. And if we fail, then we get 5 cents, and that's all she wrote. But that being said, I do want to, if we do get a devil deal here, we're going to have to use the Crooked Penny. We did not, so it is not a problem at all. And now we can see if our luck is actually truly blessed on this Saturday, or if we just got lucky one time. Dreamcatcher is going to show us the items in our item rooms from here on out, as long as I remember to look at them on the break screen. Super secret room, regular secret room, I should say, is going to give us some keys and some bit of coin, a little bit of coinage. Yeah, and you see how useful it is just to have the ability to walk in and things just die around you. You know, now again, you do have to be very cautious about the death rattles and of course bombs and that sort of thing. Not worth giving myself double guillotined. Guilotine. Down here, call that a guilotine. Hey, there we go. So you can do a little trick like that too, where if the game can't populate a doubled item anywhere near the originator, it basically just will put it at the nearest free spot, which in this case makes it actually reachable, and it worked out very well. Forgot my sun card. Oh, baby, that was Tech Point Fizzle. Tech Point 5, you know we're coming for you. Fantastic item there. One of the best support carry items in the entire game. I mean, there's not enough. You really cannot say enough about how good Tech Point 5 is. Absolutely. So, hoping for Soul Hearts. We don't have a whole lot of HP, and this is a little bit of a concerning matter. Given the fact of our tendency to get hit by death rattles right now, which is all my fault, by the way, not the work of Toxic Shock. We just got the full charge. We should go back and try to get the buff from killing a keeper in the store. Maybe even a judgment or two that we can bum, although it only count for one. And you see how weak everything is here that Toxic Shock makes it. It only requires one or two hits, and that's it. And if they get hit by an Eye of Belial tier, it's all over. That's not even close. This is a very odd map layout here for us to get to the store. Also, we have way too many Warflies around me. I wish that they would just go away. Chew Warfly, don't bother me. And thank you for those of you who've been going over and checking out the Cult of the Lamb series so far. That series has crossed the 1,500 mark for likes so far without fail, and I really appreciate it. Again, that kind of stuff, it helps bolster the channel. You know, it definitely benefits the channel to have more than one video series if possible that do very well. And the last one that we had that did, you know, pretty well was 20 Minutes Till Dawn, which I still am planning on recording more videos for that, by the way. Tiny Folks, we need to finish our Tiny Folks campaign, even though technically it the likes kind of fell off towards the end there, but we only have one more, I think we only have one more thing to do in that campaign, and then we're actually done with the game, and I can show off, like, the end game, because the end game of Tiny Folks is really cool. Gives you a whole new saga to enjoy. That's a 73% failure. The game just put us on repeat here. Okay. So that was Tech X inside of the item room. We just got done having this almost exact combo to a T, other than Tech Point 5. Now I will say that there was a lot of spirited debate about some transgressions I had on the Judas run when it comes to eye drops. I think that it is certainly more of a pause of an item right now than an automatic pickup. Yes, it does give you a good amount of tiers. If you already have tiers, eye drops can greatly benefit you. But the erratic nature of the tiers when they fire out is what's problematic for me. Now with Tech X, that doesn't matter, obviously. I mean, we did give you like 18 cents judgment. You gave us that crap. We'll take Tech X here. Tech X, it basically stops the use of eye drops. We don't have to worry about it anymore. As you see here, we still get the benefit of Tech Point 5, so it just Tech X just gives us more, just more of a dominant position here with our tiers and whatnot. It gives us that. Oh man, yeah. I as much as I like you, Crick, the Golden Cricket's leg. Yeah, having extra base damage is huge here. HP upgrade, and whoo, man, I would love to double these. I cannot pass up Empty Vessel. I absolutely cannot. Okay. Empty Vessel was the must-have of that group, and then Lusty Blood is good to have, don't get me wrong, but I'm willing to risk it for that Lusty Biscuit, if you know what I mean. Then pay it with HP and then, like, you know, end up, you know, dying or something like that. Would not be optimal. So I do feel comfortable with the amount of HP we have, so let's go back and go check out our cursed room, but first let's go get ourselves a full charge just in case if there's something in there that we may want to consider doubling. And honestly, shout out to the freaking Crooked Penny right now. Absolute madman of an item. Honestly, I'd rather have the penny. All right. So Lusty Blood, by the way, is going to give us more damage based on how many enemies we kill inside of the room, and then the buff fades out as soon as we exit the room. So it's very good for long, extended fights. And there's Nose Goblin for some reason. I believe that was the Mulligan, and we already have our teleport to get out of the boss rush. So, I mean, everything's coming up Millhouse right now for us. And honestly, I'm all for it. I feel like it's been a while since we've even seen Lamb, let alone done a victory lap. Not that victory laps, of course, are you know, a requirement or anything, but people like to see the extended laps. Just lately, with the quality of runs that we've been getting, we've not been afforded the luxury of so. Yeah, that is the Mulligan. I will take it. That's 2 of 3 for Beelzebub. Again, with our base damage going up and up and up thanks to Lusty Blood, the amount of damage that are not only our toxic shock, but our Tech Point 5 is going to increase, but also every single shot that we fire out with Tech X is going to increase. That's just all around good stuff. Blue Mom is good for us, bad for Mom. Blue Mom spawns a whole lot of adds, which again leans into the Lusty Blood buff for us. And it's going to be Krampus. Honestly, the head of Krampus is probably not too bad here. I got to go SMB Superfan. I can't risk losing that. I mean, I can, but I'm not willing to. SMB Superfan is a fantastic all stats up. Yep. I believe that our tinted skull was here. So we have a way of getting out of a boss trap room or mob trap room if we decide going there. I would have used a key to see what this card was, so. Yep. Keep myself honest on that one. And yeah, we'll just head on down. More damage from the negative. Be Triacnid boss. You're wondering how we're seeing the boss. Again, that's from the little break preview that you see. That is from Dreamcatcher. So it's a useful item. I mean, it's nothing really to write home about, but you know, it's useful to see what kind of boss you're going to be going up against, what kind of items you're going to be seeing.
Retro Vision.
Thank you, Matthias. So get ready for a minute and a half of this. It's gonna be real fun. I can't tell if there's a tinted rock in there. Usually there is. Yeah, this Tech X Lusty Blood combo is just sick, nasty, crazy. Okay, so there's a vault over here. And apparently, in order for us to go south, we gotta go northeast. For us to go southwest, we literally have to go northeast. That is Isaac, baby. We have enough bombs where I don't have to care about this room, but I'm going to anyway. Usually there is a tinted rock associated in this room. With us having a horse pill retrovision, it's impossible for me to see it. So I'm just not even going to bother. And that's a good wide spread that we've got here from Tech X. That radius that we're covering here is just absolutely massive. I'm gonna go check out our vault. Enjoy. I feel like this is probably not the right way. Although maybe. Thank God, I can finally see. Nope, you're right. All right. That soul heart was blocked by a spike rock, so I'm not going to use a soul heart to get a soul heart. It's worth it for us to try to make it work with the crooked penny. Get our soul heart back that we stupidly lost on the spikes, and it's going to be Guppy's head. Not Guppy. Yeah, let's go see old Hushy. Constellation prizes should increase our ears. Oh, movement speed. Little spewer and fruitcake. Cursed eye and mom's wig. Mom transformation there. All right. Fruitcake, I mean, fruitcake can be okay. You know, occasionally it is surprises with like a good effect or something, so sure. Now what's nice about this is that we do have Lusty Blood, and obviously Blue Baby and Hush both have really large amounts of adds, so we're gonna max out our damage upgrade pretty quickly. Did we get hit there and I just didn't even notice? I think we did. So Fruitcake's going to give us random tiers every time we fire a tier, including our Tech X shots. So you're going to see a myriad of different shapes and colors and sounds and all kinds of stuff. See all the little horn shots that we've got. Didn't even see those flies there. Here we go. Got our soul heart back, or at least one of them anyway, and our fool card. Lots of money. If you're wondering where this money's coming from, it's because we were proccing Head of the Keeper tiers. So this is going to help us out when we go on to the victory lap. And old Hushy didn't have a chance. I was going to say he had a real hush of a time, but then that didn't really make a lot of sense in my brain. You see the eye of... or the Ocular Rift shots there. Use the Chariot card against Lamb. Or Stanley. Doesn't really matter. I mean, we're just... like, we're cruising here. This is the type of run that, like, we've been kind of hoping for. This is the kind of run I was kind of hoping for, like, you know, on the Tainted Lost run as well. Which, again, those of you who haven't seen Wacky Wednesday... well, actually, skip Wacky Wednesday, trust me. But go look at Turbulent Thursday. I don't know what I'm going to be calling Thursdays yet. Go look at Thursday's run, and you missed one heck of a good time. I don't know why that exploded, but it sure did. The unicorn horn, it came off, I think, like, at the exact moment that Stanley's foot went down. It was great timing by Stanley. Death List. I will take Death's List, and then we can just pog out. Or not. All right, so now we have Empty Vessel, which is going to give us the Empty Vessel shield, but more importantly, give us flying. Well, I guess not more importantly. It really just kind of depends. Get Death's List, which is going to give us a chance for a stat up or just random stuff. No. If we're able to kill things in the order of the, in the order that they show up as denoted by that white skull that just disappeared. And a little bit difficult, obviously, if you have a bunch of ads on the screen and you have AoE. It's going to be hard to get Death List going, but we're going to take Charge of the Charm of the Vampire because it does give us a damage upgrade. Endless Nameless, no thank you. Remember, we don't have Polaroid Invincibility. We actually outran the Brimstone for once. And there you go. Absolutely. That was a nice, easy run. Enjoyed a little bit more. I can see Echo 6 Juliet 9. Bravo Papa Yankee Lima. So that was absolutely Lemon Mishap. Or Lemon Party, I should say. So we're not even going to bother going into the item... in the item room, we can still roll in the for the premium items here. We get blue map, which is, you know, I'll take it. It was free, so, and it's a useful item. Blue map's going to show us exactly where the location of the secret room and regular secret rooms are, but it will not show you the ultra secret room. Here we get stem cells. I mean, shot speed up isn't really all that useful with Tech X. You really want to maximize your uptime. By uptime, I mean, like, how long your tiers are over an enemy. And, like, dealing damage and stuff. Tech X is all about that. Oh, God, here we go. All right. Glitch Crown is a go. So, Glitch Crown, what does it do? Oh. It does that. Oh, man, Birthright. We got to go Birthright. I mean, well, Red Stew, though. Let's come back to this. Let's go see what's inside of our item room first. So Glitch Crown is going to make rotating item pedestals on every item pedestal. The tech one I see. We get Tech Whizzle. There we go. So we get the Brimstone Tech shot. Man, this is... See if we can time this. I don't know if it's going to give me an item pedestal or just give me the flipper. Oh, it just gives us more. Okay, well, I want Hive Mind here. This is going to give us Beelzebub. Then I want Birthright here. Okay. Then I do want Red Stew. I know you think I'm going to go Black Candle there, but I actually do want card reading. Actually, it would make more sense for us to take Birthright because we get essentially 12 more items to choose from. And they're all random item pools. Okay. Hey, Keeper, you're going to have to move. Okay. Well. I'm going to go Chaos. Just for the hell of it. I mean, at this point, why not, right? We've already got Glitch Crown, and we basically are Guppy. So let's just see how crazy things can get. Oh yeah, and we also have what is essentially Brimstone and Tech Axe. Go D-Bizzle. Not great. I think we go for Miter. We could just do this. Yeah, that worked out. And I think we go Ocular Rift. Or I have a cult, I mean. I don't purposely mix those two up, by the way. Miter, and then here, get a little Brimmy. I believe that was Guppy's paw. Although it is Glitch Crown. Give me Cricket Petty. I think Guppy's paw was in there somewhere. It's impossible to know because obviously Curse the Blind. Yeah, we actually did get a payout somehow. Nice little damage upgrade there. You see Toxic Shock still doing its thing. And the higher our base damage gets, the more powerful it becomes, which makes it a lot easier on us. Little chest. Again, we have no idea what we're picking up, so. Yeah, joke's on us, maybe. We do have to be a little bit careful, though, with it being Curse the Blind. Bot Fly. I'd love to have seen what was in there. But we immediately regret not taking Black Candle, lol. The other nickel here, which actually gave us a nickel. Doesn't usually happen all that way, and yeah, we just don't get to see that. All right. Well, hey, look at that. We got a luck upgrade. And we're definitely going to need it. That appeared to be Gertie Jr. Looks like one of them there Gertie Juniors. She's little and she's Gertie. She's Gertie Jr. Take Sanguine Bond. Take a chance. Oh my goodness. Well. No! The only one that I wanted and I missed it. I goofed it. Now I really, really, really wish that I was holding onto the glowing hourglass. Damn it. Oh well. See, that's what happens when you just try too hard. Warm buddy, you know I love you. Yeah, we do get a Card Against Humanity here as well. Oof. That's a good pickup. Yeah, I mean, Holy Mantle was there, but... I don't think we need Holy Mantle. The thing is that you don't need Holy Mantle when everything just dies around you. I'm just looking for an XL room like this. Good duff. Now we've already seen the petrified poop on the last run, so I doubt that we're gonna see it here. But this will still pay for itself. And we didn't spend a whole lot of money anyway. We took damage because I think something exploded. Library is very nice here with Glitch Crown. Gotta go Psyfly here too. I thought about doubling that. I probably should have. Let's see what we can get in our item room. Oh no. We've begun the breakfast routine already. I think we'll take Spoonbender here, not that we even need it, but homing shots are fine. Get ourselves a Bone Heart. It's Curse Room 2, might as well. This little gain there with Death's List. That looked like Bird's Eye, which is definitely something I want. Take Bird's Eye here. And our luck isn't that great, so we shouldn't see that much fire blinding your eyes on the screen. But if you're enjoying this run, everyone, make sure you click the like button. Like I said, I'd love to see this video get 5,000 likes. If we can do that, we can get back on track for the like streak goal, getting the Wheel of Distaste. Because people didn't like the Wheel of Hate, which I agree. I will yield to that sentiment that the Mosh Pit was expressing. I think it's a little bit too much of a bad term, and I agree. So Wheel of most disliked items. Definitely get Pyro because I'm tired of hitting myself with whatever is exploding from Fruitcake. Oh man, there's Sacred Orb there too. He's done it. I got one of the two sacreds. One of the two sacred items that we needed. Take a devil card with us here. Yeah, I would love to see those likes get piled up here, and I want to get the wheel going. And again, that might be a staple. We might do, like, if the items, or if the runs do well, the ones that we decide to go with the Wheel of dislike, you know, that might be a themed run that we can add into the rotation here every single week. I'd love to do that. Gonna go damage here. We could have taken Salvation, and Salvation wouldn't necessarily have been bad, but I don't think we're going to need it that much. Got a Yara rune. the heck is going on over here? This is just pure madness. There's our guppy item. Apparently, I guess we were already guppy. Gigante bean. I'll take. I'm gonna save the Prothro rune for the boss rush. Should be fine because we've got plenty of time to make it there. Cat of Nine Tails looks like a good winner here. And more damage, more shot speed. Shot speed, again, not necessarily something that you really want with Tech X, but when you're operating at this level of damage, it doesn't matter. It really does not matter. What's nice about the Prothro rune here is that we're going to be able to reroll all of the items in Boss Rush, which, again, in combination with Glitch Crown, that's going to allow us to go through even more items so we can pick all the juicy ones that we want. The only problem is that, obviously, we can't get out of Boss Rush when we're done, unless we find 9 lives. So we got to make sure that we get everything that we want to get done out of the way now before we skedaddle on downward. Big Bomber Boy here. I don't want to go Car Battery because it's not good with Crooked Penny. Okay. Yeah, what weekend plans do you guys and gals have? Are you playing Cult of the Lamb? Are you playing Isaac? Going out to any trade conventions or buying any trading cards? Watching Star Wars? I just now have moved on to the Book of Boba Fett. I just started it at the time of this recording. I'm not even through the first episode yet. But I did finish Mandalorian. We beat Hush. We did beat Hush. Squeezy, which doesn't actually help out our tears rate at all. So, if we beat Hush here, beat Lamb, we need to go to... We still need to beat Delirium and Mega Satan. We are ill-equipped to fight Megastan right now. There's a Delirium portal, of course. We can do Boss Rush immediately. Oh, no. Yep. Here we go. Now, this is where the shot speed... Notice, I know I didn't use the Prothro rune, but it's because we just don't need to. Remember when I was talking about uptime on targets? Yeah, C-section is like the ultimate uptime. Because not only do they move really slow, but they also home and seek. And they make sure that whatever uptime you need, you got in spades. Like, they are the quintessential. If you just stick with this item and do nothing else, you're going to be fine item. Capricorn, so we can raise the tears cap a little bit, and we just got a whole bunch of crap over here. I want my Prothro rune though. Yeah, thank you. And I do want my Devil Horn. There we go. And away we go. Okay, so we did get a sacrifice room, which means that we will be able to get a key. We cannot take Ipecac. Well, that's Guppy. I thought we already had Guppy. Apparently not. Mom's Eye, I just wanted to get rid of our red heart. Okay, so we need to get the Angel Deal keys from the sack room, which we should have enough HP to do, I think. I hope. And this is because of the Polaroid, obviously. So we did not get the soul heart payout from the sack room. But we are going to get both of our keys. And we can let D-Bizzle run around and grab all the red hearts and give us nothing but spiders. D-Bizzle. And a D-Bizzle. Give us the stars card. Thanks for nothing. And I guess let's go see what's inside of the secret room. There we go. So Omega Run possibility, but obviously we got to get past the Mega Satan block. So we can take this up to Mega Stan. Saves us one bomb. Thank you, game. We could take this to Mega Stan now that we have the key. But obviously we need to. We just got to get past it. The Mega Satan block. And if you don't know what I'm talking about. If you fight Mega Satan, there's a chance that it won't spawn you a Delirium Portal, and it just ends the run. So yes, we could use our key right now and go through the hassle of like going to Mother and you know get ready for Beast, blah blah blah. But it doesn't matter if we can't get past Mega Satan. You have to get past Mega Stan no matter what. So that's just a necessary evil until they decide to change something about the game, which not bloody likely, but you can always hope for. Look at that. We got almost back up to full HP. We've already beaten Hush. We've already beaten Lamb. We dropped Mom. We dropped everyone but Blue Baby, Isaac, Mega Satan, Beastie, and Mother, and Delirium. Delirium is the big one that we're gonna have to get to after Mega Satan. But again, that's assuming that we're able to get past the Mega Satan block. I hope we are. This is just coverage to the nth degree here. D-Bizzle for finally doing something. All right, we're going to absolutely destroy Isaac. Yep. Isaac didn't have a chance, and now we got to just hope. And we get past Mega Satan. Now, first, we have to go fight Blue Baby. Because, yeah. We just have to. Oh, my goodness. Well, we're going to go Abba Dabba Ding Dong here. We get rid of our HP. Got Leviathan. Transcendence is not actually what I wanted, but oh well. Even Baby is also not what I wanted, but we got Conjoined now anyway. And I will take... We'll take Bloody Lust. Okay, so what we can do is we can go fight Blue Baby now, and let's see if he gives us a Delirium Portal. Did. But we have no way of getting out of the Mega Satan fight now. If I had taken... If I had briefly taken the Teleport 2.0, we would have had a chance to get out of there. So let's see if we can get ourselves another item pedestal. Again, none of this really matters unless we get out of the Mega Satan fight. I'm sure the bitrate looks fine. It's gotta look fine, right? Right? Yeah. Alright, let's see if the game wants to be kind. I mean, we've had a great run. Obviously. Let me just look at this madness going on here. Mega Satan's already in phase two. You just hear the liquid hot death. We do get a Delirium Portal, so it ain't over yet, folks. So here we go. Delirium is a go, so we've got a chance. Now there's still the problem of getting around the mother fight. We need to be able to get out of the mother fight in Corpse 2 in order for us to have a chance. And the only way to do that is if there is a teleportation, if there's a sacrifice room in Corpse 2. Or we get another R key. That's essentially the only way that this works. So the Omega run looking more and more like a reality here. Oh, chocolate milk. Which is going to give us even bigger tears. Jesus juice as well. Now, another possibility is that we could get Genesis, and Genesis also is a chance for us to re-roll our run and also give us another R key. It also gives us a chance to get Death Certificate, which is what I'm kind of hoping for. Well, not now, but I'm hoping that we see Death Certificate, which is the reason why us having Glitch Crown is really, really important for us, because this is going to ensure that if we do get a Secret Room item pool... That is to say, I mean, I know we have Chaos, so Chaos kind of throws a little bit of a turd in that punch bowl. But it is possible. Oh, it's not Delirium. It is possible for us to get a Death Certificate and then get another R key, and then the Omega run is complete. Now, this might be one of the fastest Delirium kills that you'll ever see. It's not that fast, because he's going to be, you know, he's going to be flip-flopping all over the place. Not sure where Delirium is. And down he goes. All right. There we go. Now, we do not get... We do not get the ability to use our port. Take that back. Oh my goodness. Wow, what do you do here? I think you gotta go Polyphemus just for the absolute massive amount of damage. I mean, Magic Mush also, but you know. Big lead pencil here. Stores and libraries, very important for us because obviously we get ourselves more of a chance to get Death Certificate or Genesis. And I will take... We cannot take Jacob's Ladder. That's going to crash the game. So I'm going to take 9 lives instead. Take Infestation 2. It's Spider Babby. And that's Mama Mega, Anima Sola, and I am going to take the Mark. And we'll take Growth Hormones. In the Mark. We don't need Mama Mega. Now again, this Perthrow rune is going to be pretty important for us for the next boss rush that we make. But obviously we're going to have to go alt path here, which is not that big of a deal because, I mean, there's nothing in the game that's going to be able to stand in our way at this point. And alt path also might give us some more items to work with. I mean, it is going to give us more items to work with. We'll fight Wormwood here. I mean, fight is a strong word. We say fight lovingly. Judas is freaking Shadow, although I would love to get the 8-inch nails. And here, it doesn't really matter. I guess Blood of the Martyr. Or Backstabber. Couldn't see with the swarm of flies in my face. And shops are hugely important as well. We cannot take Tech Zero either. I would love to take Tech Zero, but again, that's just one of those items that are just problematic. Edine's Blessing. Remember, is not going to affect us tomorrow. Run a victory lap. Actually, no, I take that back. It should affect us because we're not on a victory lap. That's right, we used our key. E-Bizzle, go ham. Yeah, notice that we don't have the victory lap counter on the left side. That's because we are not on a victory lap. We are indeed on a fresh run with the same seed. I think that was Bag of Crafting. Not that it matters because we have Glitch Crown. Sin Robes here. Breakfast. Didn't really want breakfast, but yeah, we're starting to really run out of really run out of items here. And that is the problem with our key. It's not Arky's fault, but that's just the problem of having Glitch Crown. Because you're cycling through so many, just the sheer amount of items, like you're going to run out, especially with Chaos. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Now we gotta find the mirror, and also we gotta be careful of our, we don't want to blow up the mirror. At all. If we do that, then we die. We die and the run is over, and like it's actually like we're actually dead. I'm gonna be very cautious about where I fire in here. Luckily, Toxic Shock is still doing it for us. Oh, never mind. Okay. Never mind. It's hard to tell because the game doesn't do a good job at showing you when you're vulnerable or when you're the lost. Astral projection. You see myself a friend finder. But I also see more growth hormones over here. It's fun. Let's go back and go get our key piece. Again, we do not want to fire in that room. We can fire in every other room, but just not that room. Esau Jr., eh? Although I do like Book of Shadows here. I don't know if we have the Bookworm transformation yet. I don't think we do. The Mind of Revelation. Go ahead and take the Mind just because it allows us to see the entire map. I mean the entire map. Like, it's the blue map. It's everything combined. Blue map, compass, regular map. Whole nine yards. Don't really want the louse. Well, head on to zone. Good run. Good. I mean, hopefully we can get that that teleport out of corpse. There's Damocles here. A Damocles is going to be interesting here with Glitch Crown. I have no idea what just hit me there. I couldn't begin to tell you. Our full breakfast. Take the parasite. Take breakfast. That's proptosis, and that's also incubus. And yeah, we can take proptosis. Why not? Why not? You know? Let's go make our way back into the shop real quick. All right. Settle down there, Kidney Stone. Okay. We don't need any of these. Oh, we can't afford any of them anyway. Yeah, since we can't afford any of them, it doesn't matter if we reroll anyway. So, I'm just going to head on down to the next floor. Let's go check out this super secret room real quick. So Damocles is going to give us an extra item pedestal, which combined with Glitch Crown means that we have more chances to do fun stuff with. And look at this, we get Spin Down Die. Compound Fracture. I mean, sure, it doesn't really matter. Okay, so with Spin Down Die, Compound Fracture. Well, Spin Down Die, that opens up the possibility for another R key. Because now what we're looking for is, I think, Bot Fly? Wow, it's clutch. The new boss. Oh, he's dead. There's Vanishing Twin and there's Brimstone. I think Brimstone will cut down a lot on the visual doo-doo. I'm going to take Vanishing Twin. And none of those turn into anything that we care about. It's Divine Intervention. We could also get Cricket's Body, though, for the tears down. Just that one, that's okay. Okay. Never mind. Brimstone apparently, Brimstone doesn't matter. All right. So let's go do our mother run real quick. Excuse me. Yeah, I believe that Botfly, if we can find Botfly somewhere or roll into Botfly, that will allow us to roll into Death Certificate, which would give us another R key, which would secure the win. The Omega run. Now, if that doesn't happen, we have to hope that there is a teleportation. We have to A, get a teleport card, which we do have in the Emperor's card. And then we have to hope that there is a sacrifice room in Corpse 2. So there's still a couple outs that we can kind of hope for. Tricky. Here we go. Problem at all on that. And the game crashed. Well, I don't know exactly what caused the crash. It looked like it may have been Brimstone. Brimstone Tech X may have done something. So I think what's going to happen is we're going to have to do the mother run over again. Yep. Sure as heck are. Ooh, yeah. Ooh, that's... Yeah. All right, let's try this again, shall we? All right. Hey, our hair changed in here. That's Isaac, baby. I don't remember what the other items were that we got. And quite frankly, I think we may have to remove Compound Fracture. It doesn't look like we maintain Cricket's Body, so I just won't pick that up. But it's really annoying that Isaac... I mean, we haven't even gotten any real game-breaking items or anything like TM Trainer or, you know, any like Jacob's Ladder or anything. Like, it's really dumb that you have to remove items from the game when you didn't do anything to break the game in order to, like, finish a run. And that happens a lot with Repentance. There's just items that you know that if you're taking it, you're probably asking for a crash or two. Anything that does like AoE or like splintering or anything like that, any additional shots that you might get, generally speaking, those are kind of a no-no. At least we did that one a little bit better. Okay. So what I'm going to do, I'm actually going to go back. I'm going to exit real quick and then continue, just so we don't have to do that again if the game crashes. So just as a FYI, if you ever have that problem where you're in like sort of like you're in like a crash state, and you want to try to at least save your progress before it gets a chance to do it again, then just simply back out to the main menu and it will create a little save state that you can then go back to. We actually lost Brimstone too. Brimstone's gone, so there's a wafer. Sure, we'll take wafer. I think that was clutch. Okay. Well, we need to get our teleportation card back. Wherever our Emperor card went, which is not this. And I don't think we're going to be able to get it back. So what we're really looking for here is a teleportation card at the bare minimum. This way that we can get out of Corpse 2 mother fight is rock bottom. Missed it because there's just a billion spiders around us. Vanishing Twin. Really need Abyss either. Actually, no, I think that was Echo Chamber. All right. Well, it's a good thing that we did Boss Rush, obviously. We have our Perthra Rune. Just gonna use it now. There's Godhead and Binge Eater. We get Godhead. Oh boy. Hey, there's our Brimstone. Fear Shackles, I don't think we need any of that. We do have our Brimstone back though. This is gonna be breakfast. Breakfast in here. There's Abyss. I will take Circle Protection. Might as well. We'll get breakfast. A little bit scared about what happens when I fire any tier whatsoever. Not too bad. Oh, boy. Okay. Might have spoken a little bit too soon there. Okay, we're okay. Gonna do my best not to fire anything. But what we really need is we need to get a tarot card, a teleportation card out of Corpse. And we get a greed fight. Let's see if there's at least a reroll machine down here, and there's not. But there is Death Certificate! Okay. We can't afford it. 17 cents. All right, we need 3 cents. Done and done. You approach from this side. No. All of you come over here. Team, huddle up. Huddle up. Like, the coach needs space right now, okay? He's done it. Let's go. Now it doesn't matter. Oh, baby. Put a fork in this one, because I think it's done. I'm not going to go get the R key until we absolutely need it. Just not right now. That stairway. Ooh. Take sausage as well. So now all we got to do is use death certificate to get our key to get out of the mother fight, and that's it. All right, Bethlehem, how you doing? I know that there's a stairway there, but we don't care anymore. I think it would actually be detrimental to us to get more items on this run. Don't think that's a wise move. Yeah. So I think what I'm going to do, just because I cannot tolerate these crashes anymore, I'm going to remove probably compound fracture, anything that splinters, maybe even Tech X. So I'm going to use the console command here. We didn't lose death certificate. I'm going to remove compound fracture. And then Tech X is probably causing us a lot of problems too. Let's see. Let's start. I don't want to remove too much. But let's start with compound fracture and go from there. Nope. All right. Well. Woo. All right. Live debugging of Isaac. Live decrashing of Isaac. You're not going to stop us from getting this Omega Run game. I think we're also going to have to give myself dad's note at the end of whenever we're ready to go fight old Beastie. Yeah, so I'm just going to remove that. Remove Tech X. Remove, I don't know, Brimstone. See how that goes. I'm going to actually make a save state real quick. Okay. Do we still have Cricket's body? Hang on. Do we still have Cricket's body? Maybe remove Eye of Belial. Wow, we have a lot of items. I don't know if we... I don't actually know if we have Cricket's body, but I'm just going to remove it anyway. Again, I don't know if we have it or not. I don't think C-section is to blame, but it's hard to tell. It's because the game is, like, you know, so unstable. There we go. It doesn't matter. I'm going to take the negative here just for a little bit of extra damage. And we are on our way to Corpse. Okay, it's got to be Kidney Stone and C-section. That's the only thing I can think of. And maybe even Godhead. It shouldn't be C-section, though. We've had crazier runs. Kidney Stone and C-section seem to be a little bit of a problem. I'm just going to make myself continually weaker and weaker just to make the game work instead of, like, playing the game. Kidney Stone C-section. Okay. That might also be problematic, so I'm just gonna remove Eye of the Occult. All right, let's see how this one goes. Not sure what we have. Okay. Oh, you know what it is? It was none of those. It's freaking Ocular Rift. That's what's doing it. I cannot spell. It's late. Yeah, it's Ocular Rift that's doing that. I've had that problem before when you have a lot of shots going off and Ocular Rift goes off at the same time. Yeah, that's what it was. So let's see if we actually did get... we ended up getting ourselves a possibility of a... if we had a teleportation card, did we get a sacrifice room in Corpse? Let's just go see. I apologize for skipping stuff, but I've lost my patience with this crashing. Kind of ridiculous. Let's use Death Certificate now. Now, we don't have to worry about Glitch Crown. It will not be active in here. So all we got to do is find the R key. Should be on the right path, I think. Rock bottom. Sometimes our key, it hangs out with all the planetarium items. There's Genesis. Oh, there's our key. I saw it. There we go. Oh, baby. Our key is a go. All right, and then all we got to do is beat Mother. Now, I am probably going to have to give myself Dad's note again because that's just how the game is coded. You're not supposed to be able to do Omega runs. But we like breaking the game here, so whee! Omega run, still the same. Echo 6, Juliet 9, Bravo Papa Yankee Lima. We're just gonna hit it and rip it. We're going to see nothing. We're gonna see absolutely zero repeat items because this is our second R key, and that's fine. We don't need to. I'm hoping that we get some red portals here. So, what a run! If you're excited for an Omega run, everyone, make sure you click the like button. It's been a little while since we actually did one, and I'm really jazzed that we get another one under our belt here. I think this is like our fourth or fifth Omega run. Game just refusing to give us any red portals, and that's fine. I'd be salty if I were you too, game. And funnily enough, Damocles still has not fallen yet, which is probably going to fall like at the most inopportune moment. We cannot buy a red portal here from a card reading. This is winning Isaac on auto here. Just checking just because I'm curious. Yeah, I mean, we'll take Divine Intervention. I was kind of looking forward to using that against Mother. The second phase. Hey. Not even going to mess with it. We're going straight to Beastie. Now, there is a bug. If you haven't seen it before, there is a bug that happens where... If you... Oh, no, it's actually there. Never mind. I'll just shut up. I think it's if you trigger the victory lap out of Corpse, but I could be wrong about that. There is a situation where... I don't know if this is a... Oh, yeah, that's fine. Yeah, I don't know exactly what triggers it, but there is a situation that exists in the game where if you... do certain things out of order, Dad's note will not spawn. It's something that you've seen before here on the channel before. Pascal Candle. Look at Virtues. I mean, hell, why not at this point? Got ourselves some lightsabers that I'm fond of. It's not going to last long for old Beastie. Old Beastie is not long for this world.
You
I did get the next box, the August box, from Maestro. So I'll be doing another unboxing video of that coming up probably later on this weekend if I have time. And I'll also be announcing. There's still a lot of people who are entering into the contest for the subscription box giveaway. So I'm going to let everyone have a couple more days just so they can see it. If you haven't seen it, by the way, just go to the unboxing video that I did, the unboxing of Isaac, a couple days ago. Actually, it was like last week, exactly last week, actually. Go check that out. All you got to do is just be subscribed. No, I'm not taking Genesis. All you got to do is be subscribed to the channel, like, and comment on that video. And I'll be announcing the winners sometime in the near future. And honestly, as dumb as it got with all the crashes and everything, we still managed to beat an Omega run in under 1.5 hours, which is really, really good, all things considered. So let's go out with a bang here. Get this video to 5,000 likes on the weekend. That's a double challenge there for you, Mosh Pit. I mean, just take a look at that. That is just ridiculous. Yeah. Down goes Dogma, and the old beastie's not going to fare any better. So chippity chip chop her way down. I mean, that's just. I don't think anything's going to get by us. It's just instant death. They just run into instant death. Even War, I think, is going to run into instant death here. Yep. That'll do it. So thank you for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it supports my channel. And I really hope you enjoyed having this Omega run. I don't know where Death is. He usually likes to scamper off into the lava somewhere. I have no idea where Death is currently at. The Rim of Greed just randomly. No, thank you. We have 4 lightsabers pointed right at Beast, and that is just gonna be it. So thank you for watching, everybody. We got another Omega run down, Mosh Pit. Good way to kick off the weekend. And again, thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Greg Davis, Jaegersmann, Ty Hamamoto, Frederick Backstrom, and Charleston. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find at patreon.com/sinvicta.